So a little bit about the background of the farm is it's a family farm. I'm very privileged to be have the opportunity to farm. And my grandfather started it in 1946 as a dairy unit. Then it's evolved since then, went all arable in the early 70s. And then we've grown over the last 10 years, really, up to our present size, which is 1,600 acres. Trying to innovate and improve on what we're doing all the time is one of the key things that keeps me going, is what I enjoy doing. It'd be boring if we were always doing the same thing. We try and keep at the forefront of what we're doing and what will work on the farm. And part of my reason for working with other companies on trials, and in particular on this trial here, is that I feel that our part of the country is unique, as I think every farmer feels their part of the country is unique. And I get to find out what works and what doesn't work on my farm, on my land, on my weather, or you know, the sort of the climate that we have here, which is interesting, and that's valuable information I can then use going forward to hopefully grow better crops. The 3x3 project was sort of presented to me by Yara. I've worked with Yara over the last few years, and they gave me the opportunity to work with them and Monsanto and BASF to make the project work. And it was an exciting thing. It's slightly different to what the normal trials are, where a trial company would come in and do the work. We're actually much more involved with this. It's a slightly bigger scale as well. So that's why I was keen to do it. It's fantastic to work with BASF and Monsanto alongside Yara, just to try and get the knowledge out of them. The first thing we had to do is work out a plan, and that was done between all three companies. That the plan was put together. We then had to transpose that into a field scenario. That then led to a couple of hours out here marching around with canes, sticking them in the ground, getting everything laid out and plotted out. Trials guys came in, they drilled the small plot trials, and they left us the rest of the field to do. We then calibrated our drill, did all three varieties, did the bit around the outside, and then obviously there was the spraying on top of that, which we've done across the varieties. My impressions in terms of establishing a rape crop at the moment, I'm very, very pleased. It's been a very challenging season this year. We've lost some rape to slugs. We've had to spray for flea beetle. This field was sprayed for flea beetle, but the slugs have been okay out here. So actually, to get it to the stage it is today, I'm very pleased, particularly obviously with the trial and the extra pressure on of wanting to get it to work. The slugs haven't been so much of a problem on this field. It was all pelleted with the drill. Nothing else was pelleted afterwards. Whereas we've lost some rape in some other fields. The straw was baled off this field. That probably helped. We just don't seem to have had the problem in the barley stubble as we did with the wheat stubble. We've been precision placing nutrients for the last 3 years, ever since we've had the Gladen drill, in fairness. And it's something that I looked at as a way of improving our establishment of the rape. So we put it on the drill the first year we had it, and it works extremely well. And it made the trial extremely easy to do as well, because all we had to do was just turn it on and off, rather than actually having to retrofit anything to the drill or any extra effort. It's what we're doing anyway. We use the standard fertiliser that we're using, so there was no difference to farm practice. We tend to use one variety that we've grown before and we're pleased with, and then we'll try another variety to see how that goes for that year. This year we already had incentive from last year, and then we wanted a DK variety, so we went with Exilium. So that's what's planted in the rest of this field, and then another 50 odd hectares on the farm here. That's what's so good about having the trial on the farm here. You wouldn't normally plant 14 different varieties in one field, so we'll have some real good knowledge here to choose a variety for next year. At the moment we're just keeping an eye out for aphids or cabbage stem flea beetle as needs be. We're taking the volunteers out. But going forwards, we'll assess whether we need a plant growth regulator going through the autumn, and the same with the fungicide. So in terms of knowledge transfer, if you like, a lot of that's done by the open days that hopefully we're going to have here over the course of the year. But social media as well, with Twitter and Facebook and things. So my expectations from the trial are fundamentally to improve my knowledge of how to grow oilseed rape, whether that be through ag chems, varietal or nutritional requirements of the crop. So what I've got here is an opportunity to improve my knowledge on my farm with my weather type and my soil type.